So in the yesterday's lecture, we started with a discussion on what is statistical mechanics, and then we followed it with why statistical mechanics is important. So we said that, okay, since the number of particles we are dealing with are very, very large, because of these very large number of particles, it's very easy to calculate the property of individual molecule, but as a collection of these molecules, it's very difficult to calculate the property of whole system. For that, we need something, and this something is we are going to combine statistics and mechanics, and that is known as statistical mechanics. And how we are going to combine statistics and mechanics, that's what we are going to study in statistical mechanics. Then we discuss about what is statistics. So it deals with large number of data, and it predict how a large number of data can be treated as a single part, how a large number of particle can be treated as a single particle. Then we say that, okay, if we are going to deal with statistics, so we should know about the principles of statistical statistics. And the first principle that we discuss is probability. So we defined what is probability. After defining probability, we said that, okay, it's very important how to count. In order to find what is the probability, it's very important how to count. And then we started with counting principle. After starting with counting principle, we say we derived what will happen if the order is important and repetition is allowed. Then we said that what will happen if order is important but repetition is not allowed. So we seen those two things, and then we arrived at some formulas. So we have done something like this. So the first thing that we discuss is counting principle. In counting principle, the first thing is that repetition is allowed. And order is also important. What I mean by order is important, suppose I am flipping three coins. So what is the H, H and T? I am getting something like this. So I am going to count this and this or this separately. So this is a separate event, this is a separate event, this is a separate event. Even though there is one tail only. So I am going to count them as separate event. So this is called as order is important. So the order in which a particular event, here the tail, is happening is very important. Such a thing is there, then we say that if repetition is allowed, then the number of ways in which a given things can be done is given by capital N into N, where capital N is the number of particles or number of set, and small n is the number of slots. For example, suppose I have an energy level, and here repetition, somehow a repetition is allowed, and the order is also important, and I am going to flip it with 10 particles, and this energy level only can take 3 particles, for example. And deliberately I am saying that, okay, order is important and repetition is allowed. That time, here capital N will be equal to 10, small n will be equal to 3. Because there are 3 slots and there are 10 particles. But in principle, if you look really, if I place one particle, I cannot place that same particle again. So repetition is not allowed in this particular case. But let's consider, for simplicity, let's consider this example. So this is the first case that we discussed. Then the second case we discussed, what is going to happen when repetition is not allowed, but order is important. When repetition is not allowed and order is important, that time we said that the distribution, how I am going to fill up the energy levels, is given by permutation formula. Capital N, Pn, and this is given by n factorial divided by n minus n factorial. And we take several example to explain this particular thing. So let's discuss about what is going to happen when repetition is not allowed and order also is not important. So suppose what I have a energy level, and this energy level can take, let's say, 3 particles. I can accommodate 3 particles in this particular, I can accommodate, let's say, 2 particles in this energy level, and there are 3 particles with me. So I can put only 2 particles in this energy level, but I have total number of particles available with me is 3. So how many ways in which I can do this? So let me write it something like this. The 3 particles I am labeling as A, B and C. And let me say that the first position I am calling as 1 and the second position I am calling as 2. So how many ways are there? So agar main graphically represent karunga, to I can put A, B or I can put A and C. Right? Or I could put in the first state I can put B and in second state I can put A. In the first state I can put B and in second state I can put C. Or I could put C in the first state and A in the second state. Or I could put C in the first state and B in the second state. These are the only possibilities, correct? So you can calculate this using permutation formula. The permutation formula is n factorial divided by n minus n factorial. So that would be equal to total number of particles is 3. So 3 factorial divided by 3 minus 2 factorial. So that would be 3 into 2, which is equal to 6. Correct? But I don't know whether this and this, they are different. I only know that there are only 2 particles filled up. Correct? So this and this will be identical case. Right? So instead of counting them as 2, because since order is not important, so AB and BA, I am going to count it as 1, right? Similarly, this AC and CA, since order is not important, I am going to count it as the same thing. So this will be the second case. And BC and CB, since order is not important, pehle kon aa raha hai wo important nahi hai, right? So I'm going to call it as the next thing, so 3. So when order is not important, what's happened? The number of ways reduces. So how I am going to write this particular thing in a formula? Just like yahan pe maine ek formula likha tha permutation ka. वैसे ही फॉर्मूला में मैं इसको कैसे लिख सकता हूँ? सो दिस इज बेसिकली आई कैन राइट समथिंग लाइक दिस, एन फैक्टोरियल डिवाइडेड बाय एन माइनस एन फैक्टोरियल. दिस इज द परम्यूटेशन फॉर्मूला एंड आई एम गोइंग टू मल्टीप्लाइड बाय एन फैक्टोरियल. राइट? सो इफ आई राइट इट समथिंग लाइक दिस, आई एम गोइंग टू गेट 3 फैक्टोरियल डिवाइडेड बाय 3 माइनस 2 फैक्टोरियल into 2 factorial, because capital N is 3, small n is 2. So this will give me 3 into 2 into 1 divided by 2 into 1 into 1. Iska value 1 aayega. So this will get cancelled and I am going to get 3, jo ki iska number tha, dekho 1, 2 and 3. Right? So this particular formula is known as combination formula. So this is your combination formula. So hamare case mein hum kya karne wale hai ki we are going to look something like this. Ki suppose I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 energy levels with me. So I have 5 energy levels with me. Let's say E1, E2, E3, E4 and E5. And I have, let's say, 15 particles with me. 15 particles, and these particles are electrons. And I want to fill up, let's say 5 electrons in energy level E1, 3 electrons in energy level E3, and remaining 7 electrons in energy level E4. Right? How many ways? Are there to fill this configuration? So, kaun sa formula use karunge aap? We have three formulas. The first formula is when repetition is allowed. The second formula is when repetition is not allowed. And the third formula is when repetition and order not allowed or not important. So what is the formula? If I am saying that here I am calling this number of particle to be n, and this to be n1, n2 and n3, and I am only looking at this E1 first energy level only. So what will be the formula when repetitions are allowed? Capital N to the power small n. What is the formula for repetition not allowed? Capital N minus small n factorial. Right? And what is the formula when repetition as well as order is not allowed? Yes, correct. So these are the formulas that we have, right? Which one you are going to choose here? Suppose ki maine isme se ek particle yahan pe rakh diya hai, phir se wahi particle wahan pe rakh sakta hu kya main? Nahi. So repetition allowed hai kya? So I cannot use this particular formula. So repetition is not allowed. Okay, so I cannot use this first formula. Okay, so repetition is allowed. So yahan pe repetition is not allowed. Yahan pe bhi repetition not allowed hai. Okay. Now, can I distinguish between the pehla particle? Yahan pe pehla electron kaun sa hai? Dusra electron kaun sa hai? Tisra electron kaun sa hai? Which is the fourth electron? Which is the fifth electron? Can I distinguish between these electrons? No. So order important hogi kya? Will the order be important? No, so the order also is not important. So I am not going to use this particular formula. What I need to use? I need to use this particular formula. Combination. Correct? Okay. So, suppose this is my example that I want to calculate. So, ye kaise solve karunga abhi? So, what I am going to say is, ki I want to know what is the way for filling up E1, वो fill up होने जाने के बाद मैं देखूंगा, and what is the way to fill up E2, and ये E1 fill up हो गए, इसके वे the number of ways for filling up E1 मैंने find out किया कर लिया, then I have found out what is the number of ways to fill up E3, and what is the number of ways to fill up E4? Correct? This will give me total number of ways to fill up this particular combination. Correct? Samajh mein aa raha hai yahan pe? Okay. So I am breaking up the problem into several problems. ये आपको भी complicated लग रहा होगा बहुत problem. If you try to solve it, that time you will realize it's very complicated problem. So what I am going to do, I am going to break it up into several number of problems. So when I am going to fill up this energy level E1, what are the number of particle available with me? All 15 particles are available. Correct? all these energy levels are empty. First, I'm going to fill up this E1. So all 15 particles are available with me. I can fill up this energy level from any particle, any 5 particle from these 15 particles. So for E1, I have capital N is equal to 15 and small n is equal to kitne par, I can fill only 5 particles, so there are 5. Okay, now these 5 particles are filled. Uske baad, I am going to fill up the second energy level, next energy level, E3. Okay, now how many particles are available with me? Yes, 10 particles, because 5 particles are filled in energy level 1. So my new n will be equal to 10. For this E2, n will be equal to, capital N will be equal to 10. And small n will be how much? 3, because I am going to fill only 3 particles. E3. E2 mein toh 0 hai, toh I am going to put 0 over here. I am not worried about it. I am not... उसको फिल अप ही नहीं करना है तो आई एम नॉट वरीड अबाउट इट राइट एंड अभी व्हाट अबाउट E4 व्हाट विल बी द कैपिटल एन नाउ सो यहां पे मेरे पास 10 पार्टिकल अवेलेबल थे उसमें से 3 पार्टिकल फिल अप हो गए सो कितने पार्टिकल बाकी है मेरे पास 7 सो कैपिटल एन विल बी 7 एंड स्मॉल एन विल बी कितना होगा 7 7 करेक्ट और कौन सा फॉर्मूला यूज करने वाला हूं मैं combination formula this third one so I'm going to use this formula capital N factorial divided by small n factorial into bracket 9 capital N minus small n factorial so that will give me 15 factorial divided by 5 factorial into 10 factorial correct and for E2 10 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 7 factorial and for E4 7 factorial divided by 7 factorial into 7 factorial correct okay so how many ways are there I am using and whenever I use and जैसे कि हम ये कर रहे थे कि हमने ये प्रॉब्लम देखा था काउंटिंग प्रिंसिपल में एंड ही यूज करते हैं हाँ या कहाँ पे हाँ हाँ इनटू जीरो फैक्टोरियल सॉरी जीरो फैक्टोरियल करेक्ट माय मिस्टेक सो हियर हैज टू बी जीरो फैक्टोरियल करेक्ट ओके सो हम काउंटिंग प्रिंसिपल में हम क्या कर रहे थे कि मेरे पास एक चीज करने के इतने वेज है m वेज है एंड बी चीज करने के n वेज है सो ए एंड बी करने के वेज मेरे कितने होंगे m इनटू n राइट सो व्हेनेवर आई एम यूजिंग एंड आई एम यूजिंग मल्टीप्लिकेशन सो नंबर ऑफ वेज ऑफ फिलिंग अप दिस एनर्जी लेवल विल बी दिस मल्टीप्लाइड बाय दिस मल्टीप्लाइड बाय दिस करेक्ट सो दैट वुड बी 15 फैक्टोरियल डिवाइडेड बाय 5 फैक्टोरियल इनटू 10 फैक्टोरियल into 10 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 7 factorial into 7 factorial divided by 7 factorial correct you understand this particular thing now this 10 factorial will get cancelled with this 10 factorial this 7 factorial will get cancelled with this 7 factorial and I'm going to get something like this 15 factorial divided by 5 factorial divided by 3 factorial divided by 7 factorial and what I have I had something like this I'm going to fill up this with 5 particles I'm going to fill up this energy level with 3 particles and I'm going to fill up the next energy level with 7 particles correct and I had in total 15 particles correct so I can write it something like this the number of particle that I am going to fill up energy level in E1 I am going to call it as N1 I am going to call it as N3 and I am going to call it as N4 right so I can write this formula as N factorial divided by N1 factorial N3 factorial and N4 factorial बराबर है। राइट, सो इफ आई गिव यू एन एग्जाम्पल समथिंग लाइक दिस, कि सपोज आई हैव सेवरल नंबर ऑफ एनर्जी लेवल्स विथ मी एंड आई वॉन्ट टू फिल अप लेट्स से 100 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन दिस एनर्जी लेवल, 200 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन दिस एनर्जी लेवल, 400 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन दिस एनर्जी लेवल, 300 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन दिस एनर्जी लेवल एंड 500 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन दिस एनर्जी लेवल। व्हाट इज कैपिटल एन? कैपिटल एन विल बी समेशन ओवर आई ऑल एन आई। एन आई क्या है? एन आई का मतलब है कि फर्स्ट एनर्जी लेवल में कितने हैं, दैट विल बी एन वन, सेकेंड एनर्जी लेवल में कितने हैं एन टू, थर्ड एनर्जी लेवल में कितने हैं एन थ्री, फोर्थ एनर्जी लेवल में कितने हैं एन फोर, फिफ्थ एनर्जी लेवल में कितने हैं एन फाइव। सो मैं क्या करूंगा, एन वन प्लस एन टू प्लस एन थ्री प्लस एन फोर प्लस एन फाइव, वो मेरे टोटल पार्टिकल होने चाहिए, करेक्ट? ओके, सो व्हाट इज कैपिटल एन? नंबर 1500, करेक्ट, 1500। सो हाउ मेनी वेज आर देयर टू फिल अप दिस एनर्जी लेवल? How many ways are there to have such a combination when I have 1500 particles total? It's simple. I'm going to use this particular formula, n factorial divided by n1 factorial into n2 factorial, n3 factorial, and so on and so forth. So this will give me 1500 factorial divided by 100 factorial into 200 factorial into 300 factorial into 400 factorial into 500 factorial, correct? These are the number of ways. I'm going to call it as omega. And please remember, this will be a very large number. Why? Because I have to do something like this, 1500 1499 into so on and so forth up to 400 into 399 plus so on and so forth into 300. Into 400 factorial divided by 100 factorial into 200 factorial into 300 factorial into 400 factorial. So this will get cancelled with it, and I'm going to get, this is a huge number if you can see. Right, it will be a very large number, correct? What I have done over here, I have just write what is 1500 factorial. So 1500 into 1499 into 1498 into 1497 so on and so forth up to 400 factorial. So this 400 and this 400 are going to cancel, so I'm end up with 1500 into 1499 into 1498 into so on and so forth up to 401 divided by 100 factorial divided by 200 factorial divided by 300 factorial. So it will be a very large number. You can work it out, what will be the value of this particular number, and it will be a very 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 large number, isn't it? So even if I am only dealing with 1500 total number of particles, the number of ways in which I can rearrange these particular particles are very very large. But what is going to happen when this number of particle is of the order of 10 to the power 23? So can you imagine how big that particular number will be? It will be a very huge number. So this is how we are going to find ki how many ways in which I can rearrange the particle. This is how you are going to count. Now I'm again coming back to probability. So we started with probability, and we say that in order to find the probability, it's very important to know how to count. And we say that suppose I have some event, I'm labeling the event as J, and the number of ways in which that event can occur, I'm labeling at NJ, right? So for example, J is percentage of students. So suppose in a class, there are 50%, 60%, 70%, 80%, and 100%. So I analyze my result analysis. I'm doing my result analysis and I'm finding out how many students have scored 50%, how many students are scored 60%, how many students have scored 70%, how many students have scored 80%, and how many students have scored 100%. The data is something like this. Let's say 3 students have scored 50% marks. 5 students have scored 60% marks. And 20 students have scored 70% marks. Let's say 1 student has scored 80% mark and 1 student has scored 100% marks. Total number of students kitne ho gaye? Total number of students will be equal to, let me call it as small n, so that it will be equal to summation nj, correct? Sabka addition karunga main, so that would be equal to 30, right? Okay, so what is the probability of, agar maine usme se kisi student ko bulaya, so what is the probability that I am going to get a student who has scored 50% mark? So for that, what I am going to do, I am going to write it something like this. Nj divided by capital N. This is my probability. So P of J is equal to small nj divided by capital N. So dekho yaha pe 50%, agar main yaha pe j 50% le raha hu, event kaun sa le raha hu, 50% ka le raha hu. So number of students scoring 50% is 3 divided by 30, 0.1, correct? What will be P60? That would be 5 divided by 30. P70 will be equal to 20 by 30. P80 will be 1 by 30. And P100 will be equal to 1 by 30. Correct? These are all the probabilities, right? Now, if I add all the probabilities, what I am going to get? 3 by 30 plus 5 by 30 plus 20 by 30 plus 1 by 30 plus 1 by 30. So that would be 30 by 30, which is equal to 1. So if I add all the probabilities, always I am going to get 1. This is known as normalization condition. So, agar maine koi bhi, iska matlab kya hai? If I call any student, I am going to get any one of these students. Class mein se kisi ko bhi bulaya to isme se hi koi ek rehne wala hai. That's what is saying, I am saying over here by using normalization condition. Right? So, what we have seen? If I have an event J, then PJ is equal to number of way in which I can this event J can occur divided by total number of ways. So, number of ways in which event J can occur divided by total number of ways. This is what we have defined probability. I have just given it a mathematical notation so that it will be clear. So this is my probability. Suppose the same example I am going to take over here. So this is the example and I want to find out what is average. percentage. But what you are going to do, 50 into 3, so average percentage plus 60 into 5, 70 into 20 hai kya? 20, 80 into 1 plus 100 into 1 divided by 30. So I can write this something like this, 50 3 by 30 plus 60 5 by 30 plus 70 20 by 30 plus 80 1 by 30 plus 100 1 by 30. So what is this 3 by 30? 3 by 30 is the probability of getting P50, right? So this is the percentage multiplied by the probability. Similarly, over here also 60 multiplied by probability of getting 60%, 5 by 30. So 60 multiplied by probability of getting 60%, 70 multiplied by probability of getting 70%, 80 multiplied by probability of getting 80%, 100 into probability of getting 100%. So how can I write average value of J? How can I write it in a general formula, just like this particular formula? What is J? J is this percentage. So average value of J is equal to summation over all J's, J into Pj. I am just using some symbols, that's it. Don't worry about it. This is just symbols. These are just symbols. I am just representing it in a symbolic form. Now, if I try to plot this particular thing on a graph paper, so what I am going to do, I am going to say that, okay, this is 50%, this is 60%, this is 70%, this is 80%, this is 90%, and this is 100%, right? And on y-axis, I am going to plot number of students. So how many students are there for 50%? So this will be 1, 2, 3, 4, or so on and so forth. So I'm going to get something like this. For 50%, there are 3 students. For 60%, there are 5 students, something like this. And for 70%, there are 20 students. So this will be very large. For 80%, again, I am going to get only one student. And for 100%, I am going to get one student. This is known as histogram. And this histogram can provide us a very important thing. Now, what will be the average value? If I calculate this average value, can somebody tell me what is the average value? It will be very close to 70. 67.66%. So this will be somewhere here. So this is my average value. So the average value is very close to the probable value, most probable value. Yeah, most probable value ka rahega, 70 ka rahega, right? Dekho, 20 divided by 30, right? So the average value, what I'm trying to say over here is that the average value is close to most probable value. Right? Aur kal maine ek important statement kiya tha. Yaad hai kisi ko? I said that the most probable state is my equilibrium state. So agar mujhe most probable state ka agar kuch values calculate karne hain, to main kya karunga? Average value find out karunga. किसी भी चीज के, एंड दोज एवरेज वैल्यू विल बी माय मोस्ट प्रोबेबल वैल्यूज, वेरी क्लोज टू द मोस्ट प्रोबेबल वैल्यूज. यू आर गेटिंग माय पॉइंट? द एवरेज वैल्यूज विल बी वेरी क्लोज टू माय मोस्ट प्रोबेबल वैल्यूज. इन मेनी केस इट विल बी द सेम एज दैट पर्टिकुलर वैल्यू. यहां पे देखो, किसी भी स्टूडेंट को 67.6% नहीं मिले हैं, राइट? दिस इज एवरेज, बट इट इज वेरी क्लोज टू 70%, जो कि मेरा मोस्ट प्रोबेबल वैल्यू है. सो सिमिलरली इन स्टैटिस्टिक्स व्हाट वी डू, वी कैलकुलेट एवरेजेस, बिकॉज इट इज वेरी क्लोज टू मोस्ट प्रोबेबल वैल्यूज. मोस्ट प्रोबेबल के लिए जो कुछ वैल्यू रहेगा परसेंटेज का, उसके वेरी क्लोज रहेगा मेरा एवरेज वैल्यू. सो अगर मैं एवरेज कैलकुलेट कर सकता हूं किसी चीज का, तो मैं अगर किसी भी सिस्टम में देखूंगा तो जो कुछ मेरे मैक्सिमम रीडिंग्स आएंगे वो एवरेज वैल्यू के क्लोज में ही रहेंगे. ये हर एक बार पॉसिबल है क्या? हर एक बार ऐसा ही होगा? ऐसा है क्या कुछ? यस, जल्दी बोलो. नहीं, बहुत से बार क्या होगा कि ये भी वैल्यू मुझे मिल सकती है अगर एक्चुअल रीडिंग लूंगा तो, ये भी वैल्यू मुझे मिल सकती है, ये भी वैल्यू मिल सकती है, ये भी वैल्यू मिल सकती है, मगर ये तीन बच्चों में से 20 टाइम्स आउट ऑफ दिस 30 टाइम्स 20 टाइम मुझे क्या मिलेगा? 70 का वैल्यू मिलेगा. एंड ओनली 10 टाइम्स आई एम गोइंग टू गेट डिफरेंट वैल्यूज, राइट? यू आर गेटिंग माई पॉइंट? सो मैक्सिमम टाइम मुझे ऐसा लगेगा कि ओके 20 टाइम्स मुझे 70 मिल रहा है, तो इस क्लास में जो है वो 70 ही है परसेंटेज. सो दैट्स व्हाई एवरेज वैल्यूज आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. एवरेज वैल्यू विल गिव यू व्हाट इज द इक्विलिब्रियम स्टेट वैल्यूज ऑफ अ सिस्टम. ओके, नाउ आई कैन एनकम्पास, ये जो मेरा ग्राफ था यहाँ पे दिखाया हुआ है, इसको मैं एक कर्व से एनकम्पास कर सकता हूँ, समथिंग लाइक दिस, राइट? एंड दिस इज known as distribution. So I can write something like this distribution, and this distribution picks up at average value. And अगर यहां पर देखूंगे मैं तो यहां पर मेरा variables है, यहां पर मेरा j है और y axis पे मेरा है, let's say probability of getting j. This is my distribution. X axis पे कौन से variables है वो मैं कर रहा हूँ. So यहाँ पे मेरे percentage है और यहाँ पे probability of getting that particular percentage है, right? And this particular point is not 0, 0. This is not origin. This is not equal to 0, 0 point. So यहाँ पे देखो, ये जो मेरा average value आ रहा है, मैक्सिमम प्रोबेबल वैल्यू के क्लोज में ही मेरा एवरेज वैल्यू रहेगा, राइट? सो उससे जो मेरा लीस्ट प्रोबेबल वैल्यू है वो कुछ दूरी पे है, लेट मी कॉल इट एज डेल्टा. सिमिलरली ऑन दिस साइड आल्सो इट इज एट सम डिस्टेंस डेल्टा, राइट? सो दिस पर्टिकुलर डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम द एवरेज वैल्यू उसको बोलते हैं, क्या बोलते हैं? डेविएशन. And this deviation, let me symbolize it by delta, is given by j minus delta j. समझ में आ रहा है क्या? या बहुत ज्यादा हो गया आजकल? ओके, सो दिस इज माई ग्राफ. ये ग्राफ समझ में आ गया आपको? ओके, सो इन दिस ग्राफ, नहीं आया समझ में ग्राफ? ओके, ओके, सो दिस इज माय एवरेज वैल्यू. यहाँ पे मेरा एवरेज वैल्यू है, दिस इज एवरेज वैल्यू, और यहाँ पे मेरे कुछ अलग अलग वैल्यूज रहेंगे इस तरह से, राइट? सो यहाँ ए ग्राफ देखो आप. सो ये मेरा एवरेज वैल्यू है, ये वाला, और ये वैल्यू यहाँ पे है. दिस इज 50%, दिस इज 60%, दिस इज 70%, 80%, 100%. सो एवरेज वैल्यू से 50% कितने दूरी पे है, ये अगर मुझे लिखना है तो मैं कैसे लिखूंगा? आई कैन राइट इट समथिंग लाइक दिस, 50% माइनस 70%, विच इज इक्वल टू -20%. सो इस डायरेक्शन में कितने दूरी पे है? -20% दूरी पे है. यू आर गेटिंग माई पॉइंट? यहाँ पे 70% की जगह यू कैन यूज 67.6. एवरेज वैल्यू लेने वाला हूँ मैं वहाँ पे, बट इट इज वेरी क्लोज टू 70, दैट्स व्हाई आई हैव टेकन 70. राइट, ऐसे आप लिखोगे. नाउ इंस्टेड ऑफ दिस हिस्टोग्राम आई एम जस्ट ड्रॉइंग, उसका जो शेप रहेगा दैट शेप आई एम ड्रॉइंग. राइट, नाउ हाउ फार अ गिवन वैल्यू, दिस वैल्यू इज फ्रॉम द एवरेज वैल्यू, उसको अगर कैलकुलेट करना है तो उसको मैं क्या बोलूंगा? उसको मैं बोलूंगा डेविएशन. एंड एट दिस डेविएशन विल बी जे माइनस एवरेज वैल्यू. एंड व्हाट विल बी एवरेज ऑफ डेविएशन? एवरेज ऑफ डेविएशन विल ऑलवेज बी इक्वल टू जीरो. कैसे, क्या एवरेज कैसे कैलकुलेट करता हूं? एवरेज में कैलकुलेट करता हूं जे इंटू पीजे ओवर ऑल समेशन, समेशन ओवर ऑल जे. करेक्ट, सो एवरेज वैल्यू ऑफ डेविएशन विल बी इक्वल टू समेशन ओवर ऑल जे, जे माइनस डेल्टा जे इंटू पी ऑफ जे. करेक्ट, सो दिस विल बी इक्वल टू समेशन ओवर ऑल जे, जे इंटू पी जे माइनस समेशन ओवर ऑल जे डेल्टा जे इंटू पी जे. अभी ये तो कॉन्स्टेंट है मेरा एवरेज वैल्यू, वेरिएबल है क्या ये? कुछ नहीं है. सो इट डज नॉट डिपेंड ऑन जे. सो आई एम गोइंग टू गेट समथिंग लाइक दिस. व्हाट इज दिस? जे इंटू पी जे समेशन एवरेज वैल्यू ऑफ जे, एवरेज वैल्यू ऑफ जे माइनस एवरेज वैल्यू ऑफ जे इंटू समेशन पी जे. व्हाट इज समेशन ओवर ऑल जे पी जे? नॉर्मलाइज है ना, इज इक्वल टू वन. So I am going to get J minus J which is equal to 0. Right? So the average value of deviation will always be equal to 0. So I have a problem. मुझे अगर उसका एवरेज पता करना है कि ऑन एन एवरेज ये वैल्यूज कितने दूरी पे है, फ्रॉम एवरेज ये वैल्यू कितने दूरी पे है, ये वैल्यू कितनी दूरी पे है, ये वैल्यू कितनी दूरी पे है, उसका एवरेज अगर मुझे कैलकुलेट करना है तो मैं कैलकुलेट नहीं कर सकता हूँ. सो उसके लिए वी यूज व्हाट इज नोन एज स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन. एंड दिस द फॉर्मूला फॉर स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन इज, इट इज अंडर रूट ऑफ डेविएशन स्क्वायर. Okay. So what we will do, we'll stop over here and we'll start our discussion tomorrow from this particular point. Thank you for your time.